Hey everyone, Robasorz here, and welcome back to the channel, and we are back with some more Vampyr, which is not spelled the way you would spell Vampyr, if you want to know that. So, obviously, today's episode we're going to be looking at Chapter 3, which is called... wherever it is. Yeah, Causes and Effects. So, no, Chapter 3, Family History. Establish a connection between Vampyr epidemic and the Spanish flu. So we've got to go and tell Edgar Swansea about the bloods which we analysed in the previous episodes. Right, let's go. It's not that far. I believe he's here. No, he's not here. Is he in here? Where the hell is he? Oh yeah, there he is. Edgar! They're very suspicious. Tell us once about Razvan's blood. Razvan.
Evening, Edgar. Could I get your professional opinion?
Please speak. But I have something important to tell you.
This strain of flu, it's very different from the one I saw in Europe. It's downright peculiar.
Really? What makes you say that?
Everyone's turning to vampires.
I've just looked at the blood of one of our recently deceased.
I see. Do you have anything more to go on?
No.
This disease spreads and looks like the Spanish flu, but its effects differ greatly. The London strain is different from the continental one.
This is very interesting. Did you find something else?
Yes. Unlike the flu, the infected begin to show an increase in outwardly aggressive behavior. More than simple agitation. Once docile people become violent.
You mean like rabies? Is there a chance we could create a vaccine, Jonathan, like Pasteur? By the stove, that would be smashing.
There's a lot we're not seeing here, but it is spreading, and quickly. If we don't act, the whole city could be lost.
Jonathan, we've a fantastic opportunity sitting right here in front of us. A weapon of choice.
What on earth do you mean?
Why, you, my dear boy. With your expertise and your blood, we could isolate the properties that course through your veins. Think about the possibilities.
I thought about it, and I'm in. Maitland's my realm.
And why not? What did Stoker say about the children of the night? Well, using my blood, I could create a whole army of vampires.
Surely you're joking.
We'll discuss this more later.
But don't think we are joking, Edgar.
No, thank you, Jonathan. But as I said, I needed to talk to you.
Oh, still.
I have some rather bad news.
Oh, what?
Yes?
I'm afraid it's your sister.
My sister?
Yeah, we know
she's
bitter.
To be buried this evening at Whitechapel Cemetery.
Oh.
Your mother published the obituary this morning.
I see.
I'm sorry, Jonathan. Please accept my condolences.
I was in the tomb. Attend Mary's funeral. We're attending the funeral of our sister, who we killed unknowingly. No, shut up! You're in hospital. I'll fix you.
My murdered sister's funeral.
Yeah, who you murdered?
I can't forgive myself. I'll find the truth about what happened to us. I swear.
Now, where am I going? Oh, God, what have I done? Reach the Stonebridge Cemetery. Black Wolf. Sorry, Rat, I need...
This is despicable.
Thank you. Get up, Jonathan. Bludgeoning him to death. Grease. Why do I need grease? Grease saves the world. Feed on him, feed on him. We are the shadows of the night.
Dear sister, I don't know if I have the strength.
You are safe, madam. You are safe.
Are you all right, miss?
I don't know. Who were those people? They wanted to kill me. Why?
They've lost their minds in the epidemic. They won't come back for now.
You seem to know a lot about them, sir.
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reid. I'm investigating this disease.
I am Xiao Shun. Thank you so much for helping me, Mr. Reid. I must go to the cemetery now. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Oh, he's looking at us. No, we're not killing the rats. Oh. Feeds, feeds.
Since I can't reveal myself to my mother now, I must find a discreet spot to attend the ceremony.
Why can't we reveal ourselves to
our
mother?
I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. We commend unto thy hands of mercy, most merciful Father, the soul of our sister departed, and we commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Mother. I was going to push her in.
Why kill my Mary and stick her here in this cold, god-awful place?
These are the legal requirements for the epidemic, madam.
Oh, Avery, I feel so tired. Please take me home.
Yes, madam.
Can she not see us? Oh, there we are. What have I done?
If I could only change one thing. One thing. This is a nightmare.
Jonathan, there is nothing you can do but accept it.
That? Yes,
what
I know it's
you
like
here.
Ashbury.
I thought you could use the company. I am so sorry for your loss, Jonathan.
She was a good person. Vibrant, full of life. She was kindness incarnate, my Mary.
You're a good person, Jonathan. And a young Ekon. A newborn cast into the night without so much as a candle to guide your way.
She had been scouring the most dangerous parts of London in search of me. And it led to her death.
Jonathan, don't.
I still hear her last thoughts. They echo in my head. Her mind shattered, and it haunts me.
Jonathan, stop. Listen carefully. You must come to terms with this. You must learn to live with what happened.
I know. Tell me
how is it possible?
Tell me.
Is it so easy to take a life every night and then just smile and nod at those you spared?
Don't you see? You're doing the work of our enemies, feeding your remorse. We are weakest when we grieve, and the guilt blurs our senses.
And so this is why you're here. To warn me. You felt this pain yourself. You too have endured this.
I don't want to lose you, Jonathan. I've lost so many friends.
Oh, so we're friends now, are we?
Loved ones. Pray for Mary's forgiveness, if you must.
You may be right.
Of course.
I've stared upon this world for centuries.
And time has taught me to deal with guilt, if not erase it.
What should I do then?
St. Mary's Church is not far from here. Go there and make your peace. Find the solace you need.
My lady wants me to confess.
No, Jonathan. It's you who wants to confess, I think.
Goodbye, Mary. Reach St. Mary's Church. Where's that? Oof, over here.
And off to church he goes, a newborn seeking divine consent to lick the blood from the soft and pointy crown.
Who are you? Make yourself known.
Newborn, you reek of guilt and pointless compassion. Shed your skin, forget your old weaker self.
What do you want from me?
What the hell's that? Oh, there's a big boy.
Ascalon does not approve of lone wolves who bring unwanted eyes to our pastures.
So your name is Ascalon?
Ascalon's will is vampire law. Learn them, abide by them, or I shall return as your judge and jury.
Mm. These immortals try my patience with their plans and unsolicited counsel.
Elite!
Save me the church, I wish you get mad, I'm trying to get in there. Forgive me, Father, for I have sins.
Yes? What is it that you want?
I'm sorry to disturb you at such a late hour.
No worries, my son. I'm still quite awake, having just returned from a funeral.
Yes, I know. I've forgotten what I wanted. I don't know.
May I help you, child? You seem somewhat perturbed.
I haven't the strength to cross the threshold. I wish to pray. To cleanse my soul.
The church is shut by order of the bishop. But I'm still the vicar of St. Mary's, if that is any use to you, my son.
You seem to me a good soul, vicar. But this is a personal matter.
There are no secrets from God, my son. If your heart needs comfort, consider me your chapel. For I can be as silent as stone.
I've words for one departed. They're not for living ears to hear.
Your eyes burn with rage, yet I see the pain that lies beyond. I am here to lighten the burden of all God's creatures. Whatever you tell me is between us and the Lord.
Very well, priest, as you seem quite adamant.
Open your heart, my son. Tell me what burdens you. With whom do you wish to speak?
My sister, Mary.
She was my sister.
You seem so troubled by the loss of this girl. What happened to her?
She has been laid to rest. That's all you need to know.
I see. And how are you feeling?
She died because of me. How do you think I feel?
I have a final question for you, my son. This is of the utmost importance.
Ask your question, Vicar.
I don't
get her. What would you like her to know?
Oh.
I killed you. There's no excuse. My dear Mary.
We just got a bloody vicar and we killed her.
Forgive me.
You have been heard, my son, and your burden will lighten.
He doesn't
your
seem
words
by
are sincere. Go in peace now and live your life in the way she would have wanted.
Oh, thank you. That was easy.
Whatever happened on this dock is between my sister and I. It does not concern God at all.
Me, Edgar Swansea, at the hospital.
Crush the leech, boys!
I don't want a marker. Take it away.
A leech! A leech! Oh my God!
I'm on fire!
Over there! There's gonna be an inferno!
Who's talking? Who goes there?
You. I remember you.
Oh, we're talking to her.
Fear be gone. I would harm no child of my making. This is your doing. You made me. Made me this creature. What are you? I am the land. You are our champion.
Champion?
Tell me what you are.
I am the whitened bones and blackened soil. The land made blood coursing through thy veins.
What is it you seek?
This age is sickly. An ancient poison, an older rage, brewed in a cauldron newly forged.
This has something to do with the epidemic. Making decisions for me, pretending to know how I should feel or behave.
Oh, that's not bad.
So the vampire who made me is some sort of disembodied entity? Or was he just projecting this vision in my mind? Maybe Edgar can help me with this one.
God protect us. You've got a leech in the hospital.
Who's that?
Yes, my hospital. My mission is to heal while you go about warring.
You've set the table for a snake. I wonder why there's venom in your food.
I'm growing tired of your song. You're a woodsman, McCallum, not a doctor. Return to your hunt.
Remember, I've a good nose for machinations. I can flare the scent at a mile. You can't hide from the guard.
I'm gonna kill
Jonathan. This is sacred ground, neutral territory. And I just had the carpet cleaned.
Oh, that's right. All he cares about is the carpet.
By the sacred stole, this is very bad news. Bad news indeed.
What happened?
The hospital has been attacked. We have injured patients, at least one dead and several missing. This has spiraled out of control. Even the most infirm are asking to be allowed to return home.
We cannot have the people lose faith in this institution. This hospital is their
but
only
I didn't
home.
Look of at course, the options. You're right. I saw that one. Like,
but
yeah,
we cannot afford
good.
A public scandal. It would ruin us. We must restore order, and quickly.
You mentioned a dead patient. Who is he?
She, Jonathan. She was Miss Harriet Jones.
Harriet.
I found her room like a slaughterhouse. Blood everywhere. The duty nurse is taking care of the mess.
Very
I'll
well.
Help you, Edgar.
I'll help you.
I know this place means something to you. I have noticed how you suppress your appetite when around the staff and patients.
You need to know you can trust me, Edgar.
I do, dear fellow, I do.
Please then, tell me.
Sean Hampton, the man we thought we'd saved at the docks. It seems he was infected after all.
So yes. Hampton became more beast than man.
Exactly. And now Guard of Prewen suspects the hospital of vampire activity. Do you realize what that could mean for us?
Rest assured, I will protect you and your staff.
McCallum is a fanatic. The guard will stop at nothing. You don't know what they're capable of, Jonathan.
Very well. Since I brought Mr. Hampton here, I will put an end to this.
We've got to kill him. The sad saints of the East End. Put an end to Sean Hampton's
Sean
savagery.
Hampton lives and breathes for the well-being of his flock. There's no other place he would go but the docks.
where are we going then? Take a left.
Come on, fight for us.
Got a headache. Come at me. Come at me, bro.
Best stay back, sir.
Get our weapons ready. We found one. Shit. You'll pay for that.
Stable here now. Got information about Sean Hunter's location.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Reid. May I ask you a few questions?
Who are you? What do you want?
As I just told you, I'm a doctor. From the Pembroke Hospital, actually.
The Pembroke Hospital, you say? I ain't paying any bill left by Clay.
I'm not here to collect payment, Miss...
Miss Edwina Cox. So what do you want then? Fancy buying something from me, maybe?
Not actually. No.
I'm looking for Mr. Sean Hampton. Do you know where I could find him?
The sad saint? I heard he was mugged or something.
Yes, he was. But he left hospital recently.
You don't say. Well, I suppose it's good news for the homeless and the useless. Ask them, they must know something.
Goodbye, Miss Cox. Not a drop of blood left in his body. This is the work of a vampire.
Whatever do you mean? Did she just
read our thoughts? I'm a tracker of these creatures. A vampire hunter.
You best be off to your hunting then.
I'm right here.
The sewer dog is back. And hunting all these poor folk, he needs a catching.
A sewer dog? What's it look like?
It's an old story. A monster.
You are, Tom.
Good evening,
Tom.
Good evening, sir. How are you tonight? Back to the docks, are we?
You remember me, then?
Of course I do. You're that man who seemed so lost when he entered my bar a few nights ago.
Thank you for your hospitality. I'm Jonathan Reid, by the way.
I'm still Tom Watts. Welcome back, Doctor.
Tom, I need to find Sean Hampton as quickly as possible. I've been told you could help me.
I heard the sad saint was recovering at Pembroke Hospital. Did he leave or something?
I believe he returned to his flock. Can you confirm that?
Oh, I bet you're right. Sean can't help but worry about the poor and sick.
Oh, what a generous man.
I guess it has something to do with what happened to him as a baby.
Please, tell me.
Well, I don't like to gossip, but I heard that the sad saint was abandoned as a baby in front of a Catholic orphanage in Dublin. That would explain his faith and need to help everyone.
The important thing is I find him, quickly.
Why not try his night asylum? He takes care of those who need a meal or a roof there.
Where is it?
It's in an old warehouse, northwest of here. Just follow the bank to the west and go north when you reach the end of the pier.
Thank you, Tom.
Goodbye, Mr. Watts.
Jimmy the Spark.
Seems like the guard of pre-war is on Sean Hampton.
I really should have gone the wrong way.
The wounds on this corpse are deep, the result of rabid rage. If this is Sean's doing, he's become a murderous beast. I cannot enter.
What
It's locked, all right.
Okay, am I going for this way? Again, this is going for everyone here. That shelter's facility. Sean Hansen was not shelter.
Good evening, miss. I'm Dr. Jonathan Reid. Can I help you?
A fancy doctor lurking at night by the docks? Not fishy at all.
And what about you? Working outside at night in this dangerous part of town?
You want to know my secret? I'm trying to earn money. And I'm Lottie Paxton, by the way.
Okay, cool, don't care.
I'm looking for Sean Hampton. Can you help me?
Mr. Hampton must be in his office at the night asylum he manages, I suppose. Why do you want to see him?
He was a patient of mine at the Pembroke Hospital. But he left abruptly.
I see. Well, Mr. Hampton is a discreet and dedicated man. I'm sure you'll find him soon enough.
Goodbye, Miss Paxton.
Hey, Sean.
Why the long face, Doctor?
Look at your bloody face, mate.
Is it all that worries you, Sean? My long face? Really?
This is a blessing for me, to become a Skull. Immortality gives me more time and energy, if truth be known, to run a shelter. What more could I want?
Since you left Pembroke, the amount of blood that has been shed, it's hard to believe you, Sean.
Ask what you will. As the Lord is my shepherd, I will not speak a lie to you.
Here, actually.
Aren't you afraid of what you've become?
We are blessed, Doctor. Can't you see it? The Lord has made us able to walk amongst the plague and aid those that need it.
Do you think this is a blessing when God's own house and holy symbols repel you?
If that is your burden, Doctor, so be it. But I do not fear the cross, nor am I forced to take the life of another. My kind doesn't share your imperfections.
You killed a woman,
but you must drink blood now to survive.
No, not your scripture. Whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood hath eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day, so saith the Lord. I only need to eat flesh, no blood.
Why did you kill Miss Jones at the Pembroke Hospital?
Killed old Harriet? You must be mad, Doctor. Why would I do such a thing?
Because I was in a mental case now.
So you claim Miss Jones' death was not by your hand, nor the other incidents at Pembroke?
Though Harriet was an angry, spiteful woman, she was one of God's creatures. I have nothing but love for all he has made.
I have nothing but love.
But you were close to her.
Of course. But she was lost, separated from the fold. She did not see the hand of the divine in my blessed condition.
People have been murdered. I've seen the blood. I don't believe you can be trusted.
Have a little faith, Doctor. If you will follow, I will guide you to the light.
How do you plan to do that?
Take this key of the old sewers. The entrance is by the riverbank, south from here. There you'll find all the proof you need.
Very well. You have definitely intrigued me. I hope you're right, Sean.
I'll be here when you return. If you still think I'm a threat then, well, I'll surrender myself to your judgment.
Give a dog a bad name. Locate the sewer's entrance.
So much noise. A vampire kills in utter silence.
What are you on about, mate? Lower Thames. We're going into the sewer entrance now. Oh, I wonder what we're going to find. Whether Sean's actually telling us the truth. I feel like we should have leveled up though. Explore the sewers.
That doesn't work.
I don't know what we're doing.
These wheels control the water level. Gate should shut properly now.
I wasn't expecting to have puzzles in the game. will I do now? Click on this. Okay. I don't really like the sound of that noise though. It's like they're ringing the dinner bell. Something's killing something. What am I looking for in the sewers then? So we're going down. Oh, it's him.
These maggots have escaped the wrath of Ascalon for too long. It is time to purge the sewers of their filth.
You again.
Oh, yeah,
the one they call the sewer dog.
Hold your tongue, newborn. Or I'll crush you like a maggot.
You've let the beast consume you.
Finally, a touch of lucidity. Slow as a snail.
Oh, yeah, we got him. That was a difficult fight, that was. I mean, if we was a little bit higher level, then that could have been much easier, but I made it more difficult. Defeat the beast. Defeat Virgil. The door has been unlocked.
At least one Skull escaped Virgil's wrath. How could he have made it this far? There's blood everywhere.
I don't know if I'm going the right way. anything.
Safe we are still. Drink now.
Bless you, Bridget.
Hello.
This isn't the blood of a vampire, but it will quench your thirst.
What is going on?
This is our domain, not yours. You've been warned.
Wait, I saved you from this creature. That must count for something.
Thank you. Now go. Go back to the streets and houses. There is no love lost between us, vampire. But thank you.
Sean Hampton sent me here. I believe he wanted me to find you. Who are you?
Oh, that's Sean.
If you must know, they call me Old Bridget.
Why Old
Bridget? And this
Bridget?
Shelter is where we live.
I'm Jonathan Reid. I'm a newborn Echon. I'm afraid I'm not sure what's going on.
I shall not bend a knee, young Echon, but I sense your pain. Ask, and I will afford you my attention.
Why was that creature after you?
Fergal is the blunt instrument of the Ascalon Club. His masters would see us dead or turned into slaves if they had their way.
Well, he's dead now.
What the hell was that thing? He wasn't an Echon or a Skull.
They are known as Volkod, an ancient offshoot of immortals. Blood drives them, enrages them.
What of this Ascalon Club?
Ascalon.
Vampire society's elite in the Empire. They make the rules and enforce their judgment upon us whom they see as lessers.
So is it you that Sean Hampton sent me to find?
Perhaps. The sad saint was always kind to us.
Well, that's a yes then.
He must trust you if he revealed our location.
Sean is a Skull. All those I've encountered have been violent, crazed creatures. How can he be any different?
Maybe because he is the sad saint. Or perhaps because I am Old Bridget of the Sewer Skulls.
Sean killed a patient of mine. And that's just one of the murders he's being hunted for.
If you refer to Harriet, she is now among us and under our protection.
What?
Harriet Jones is alive. That's it. That's the proof Sean wanted me to find. I must talk to her.
No. Harriet is not alive. But you can speak to her.
What?
I must warn you. She is fragile and may not receive you warmly.
I don't understand.
She is filled with bile and hate. Her mind is sharp as a tack, but her body is so weak. I've never seen its like before. She is resting in a room on the far right of this hideout.
Thank you. I will bear that in mind.
Thank you. Get out of my way. Hurry up. Is it really you, Harriet?
Hello, Harriet. Do you recognize me?
Yes. You were from the Pembroke Hospital. The young doctor. So full of secrets.
I have so many questions I need to ask you, Harriet. If you would.
I love questions. As for the answers, you may not like them.
How do you feel?
I can't. See, I can't move. My body's burning. I feel as if I'm dying over and over again.
Have you tried to eat or drink something?
People here tried to feed me, but I'm just not hungry. I don't have the strength.
Is it painful?
Does the pain ever stop?
It is not pain I feel. It's like I can't stop feeling every inch of my body.
Every inch of
At the
my
same
body.
Time, Each muscle and bone is the wrong place.
Your room, the blood. What brought you to fake your death in such a gruesome fashion?
To see if I would be mourned.
Why flee with Sean Hampton?
Oh, it's always a pleasure to see a saint fall to sin. But the coward still won't kill.
Do you take pleasure in causing so much pain and sorrow?
Nobody gave a damn about me. Not a tear shed. Poor Harriet. Always the discarded.
Always the discarded.
I have a question of the utmost importance to ask. Will you answer?
No.
Questions, questions, questions. The good doctor, always searching for answers.
Do you remember what you did after leaving the hospital? Did you kill anyone?
First, a question from me. You answer first.
Very well, then. What do you want to know?
Are you like me? Are you also dead?
We are not dead, Harriet. Death no longer pertains to us. We are different.
We are undead.
I like what I am. I truly do. I relish the pain that courses through me.
I know you fled the hospital with Sean Hampton. Did you or Sean kill anyone in your flight? Anyone? Try and remember.
I will not lie. I wanted blood, and I wanted revenge, and Sean pulled me from it, brought me here instead. But the shadows heard my prayers. The shadows killed that bastard.
Actually, it was about me.
Who was that man? The one murdered in the street?
He used to be my landlord. I lived here for many years before falling ill.
So you have killed somebody then?
Oh, he was an awful man. Disgusting and cruel. So cruel.
Shadows? Tell me what you saw.
The shadows. They heard me and answered. Something in the deep darkness. Quick. Deadly. It asked me if I wanted revenge. I answered, yes.
And these shadows, this presence, do you still hear it? Was it a vampire? Did Sean see it?
It spoke only to me. And now it is silent, but it is born of hatred. And it will kill again. And it hates you, Doctor. Oh, it hates you.
What makes you say that?
It whispered your name, Dr. Reid. It wanted to know who you were and where you went.
Questions about me? What did you say?
Nothing, Doctor. I said nothing. There was nothing it didn't already know. Oh, I'm tired now. Let me rest.
Let's just nick everything. Oh, God.
Have you found the answers you were looking for, young Ekon?
There is too much left unanswered. So many questions.
Get to know us. Spend time with us. And I may be willing to answer more questions.
For how long have you been in hiding here?
Skulls have been hiding under London since vampires first entered the city.
Where did you hide before the sewers?
We claimed ancient tunnels, forgotten caverns, catacombs. We are skulls, groveling beneath the feet of our makers.
Why do you live here, amongst the filth and vermin?
Live. Here we hide.
What are you hiding from?
Or who?
From the guilt, the shame, from the hunters and the light, and of course, our past.
Why don't you leave the city? Hide somewhere far from the Guard of Priwen, the Ascalon Club.
We are the Sewer Skulls. This is our domain. We have run as far as we can, and now we hide.
Your diction, your words. You do not carry yourself like most Skulls I've encountered.
True. I'm not like most Skulls.
You were once someone else. What happened to you?
It is as sad as it is long, young Ekon, but it will remain mine.
Can I be of service to you?
We ask but one thing. Reveal to no one our secrets. Do not betray us.
No worries, I will not betray you.
What manner of creature is Harriet? She is different from everyone else.
I really don't know. I'm not even certain she is a Skull. I've no idea as to what blood made her.
What is a Skull, in fact, in your honest opinion?
The progeny of a vampire, disavowed by her maker. Perhaps a fruitless branch of a noble tree. A word used to enslave us. I cannot say.
You mentioned that vampire blood has tremendous potency. You believe it to be stronger than your own?
The vampire's sweet blood. That rich, dark wine that we crave. For it made us, and it can sustain us.
I thank you for your time, madam. I must go back to Shaunhampton now.
Is there a shortcut by any chance?
Your kindness has been ample payment, Ekon. To protect us, I'll close the access to our hideout, but you can use our shortcut to reach Mr. Hampton's shelter.
Thank you very much.
Just follow the arrows.
Bye.
Thank you, old Bridget. I hope we'll meet again. It's locked.
What arrows? Get out of here. Oh. Ah, there's the arrows.
It's locked, all right.
Oh, that's locked. There we are. And the art. Loading screens take ages.
Hmm.
Pete.
Welcome back, Dr. Reid. Would you like to take communion with me now?
Sean, are you eating raw flesh?
It is the sacred flesh of the mortal lamb. Our Lord's bountiful transmutation for the sustenance of his believers.
That's a mad one, the Sean is.
Thank you, Lord. I am your most humble servant.
So, true to your word, you waited for my return.
I told you, Dr. Reid, I was a man to be trusted. Did you have words with the poor Harriet?
You make no distinction between the living and the skulls, do you?
We are God's children, Dr. Reid, one and all, and he's determined to save us.
What will be the result if you continue to assist both skulls and the living?
For the last decade, that's what's been happening. And they found a better life. What's to change?
You're forgetting the epidemic. Things can go south very quickly. I've seen it.
Oh, these are terrible times. Only those pure of heart shall prevail.
You've turned skull now. Don't you see the danger to anyone giving you their trust?
We are all sinners, awaiting salvation. This is a simple truth, ordained by the Lord Almighty. I am a seeker of his glorious light.
Does this place belong to you? How can you be so certain you can keep it open?
This warehouse was once property of the Dawson family, but has been bequeathed me through donation.
Harriet. Miss Jones has been behaving in a most violent manner.
Mrs. Jones.
She's going to need special attention.
That's precisely the reason I brought her here. To meet old Bridget. She's the guide Harriet requires.
Who is this old Bridget?
I don't know, Doctor. She rarely speaks of her past, but I know she has a long one. She's likely the oldest soul in the city.
Harriet is possessed by her hatred. You cannot let her roam free. She's dangerous.
She has joined her own kind, Doctor. Old Bridget is a saint to the younger skulls, guiding them to salvation and peaceful existence.
Yes, I'm absolutely
mad. I believe I've learned all I need to know. I'm certain you've killed no one, but one day I believe you'll cross the line.
Logic is a false prophet. Faith is the only path to salvation.
What do you mean?
We have been blessed with God's eternity. We are the instruments of his divine will. We shall feed the hungry forever and ever. Amen.
I will strive to emulate your merciful nature, Sean, but it's a difficult pledge to make.
Give yourself over to God, Doctor. Expel your urges and kneel before the Lord in praise.
Urges. You know the hunger will never be satisfied.
I've come to embrace the everlasting craving. I have sworn to feed only upon the flesh of the dead. It is now my sacrament. Take, eat. This is my body. So saith the Lord.
Spare him. He hasn't killed anyone.
I believe you, Sean. In fact, I envy the peace you found and will remember it.
I reckon we're going to be a good vampire in this.
You only need to give it wings.
Just killing everyone.
Thank you for your kind words, Sean. Continue your noble efforts. You are a good man in bad times.
Keep to the light, my friend.
If I keep to the light, because someone kill me.
You have a home here. Anytime you're in the neighborhood.
sacrificial lamb, take care of Sean's veins.
Another corpse thrown in the streets. Someone's playing a very sick game. I know this brooch. This is my mother's.
Oh.
A birthday gift from father. ...29 Pretty Orchard Street. That's near Poplar's district. Why would this man carry off my mother's brooch? I must go there.
Because she's the one who killed him. Locate the man's flat in the barrow. Search the flat. Right, is there a... hide out here, so we need to level up. Well, hello. Increase our health. Yes, please. Increase your life regeneration when using button in combat. Oh, science. No. Here's a damage inflicted when using button in combat. Is there any more we can do? That's it. The following night. I get the man's flat in the barrow and search the flat. Oh, hello.
Send you back to the fucking grave!
They're back to the fucking grave.
Best stay back, sir. Look lively! It's on to us! Die, first!
I'll die! Finsbury Gate. This must be the flat.
29 Pretty Orchard Street. This is it. What's in there for me? There's been a fight here. This window was shattered with violent force. Someone's been pulled through it and dragged through the street. Who could have done that?
Oh, don't say that's our mother. No, that's our mother.
The marks on this woman's neck were made by the fangs of a vampire. Only a golden watch in her pocket.
Beautiful watch.
Her shoes and clothes are quite worn out.
That rose?
This is the very flower my mother tossed on Mary's coffin. Someone is targeting my family. Right then. It's a sick game. But given no choice in the matter, I might as well win it. Won't let you escape. You're very fast, but I'll catch you. They've all been butchered.
Oh, jeez. Jeez!
I can still sense a presence.
In the name of Christ, someone please help me.
Come to me.
Oh, God, this is horrible.
Please help me.
Confront the mysterious vampire.
You! What have you done?
Oh, it's you.
Vicar Larrabee. What happened?
Demon! Hellscourge! Son of perdition!
Vicar! Vicar! Jonathan's no demon. He's just a soul. Returned Mary. From the dead. Like your Christ, Vicar.
Mary.
Really?
Is it really you?
Oh, what are you doing here? Right. Fancy seeing you precious here, Mary. Brother.
What is Mother doing here?
I'm gathering the family. For a final reunion, all smiling, all dead, thanks to the good Dr. Reid.
Mary.
Mother, say hello to your son.
Hello, Jonathan.
Hello, Jonathan.
Mother, I...
What do we have here, Mother? The prodigal son has lost his tongue. Our Jonathan always had the first and last word at dinner. The entertainer, the star of our show.
I'm sorry. Let me explain.
Shut up. It's my turn to do the talking. I have this nasty hole in my chest, Johnny. It needs to breathe.
Of course. You can speak.
My prayers went so long without an answer. My husband, killed in France. My child, carried away by the flu. My brother promising to return in his letters, then disappearing in thin air. I went from hospital to hospital, cemetery to cemetery, grave to grave. I've lifted every stone in London, searching for an end to the nightmare. And there you were, in front of me, on a dark pier.
The hunger had taken me.
The joy to have finally found you. I longed for your arms, a final happy ending to so much tragedy, to tell me all would be well again, as you did when we were children. It was this filthy dock where you greeted your sister. I dug a tunnel from my grave with my fingers and teeth.
Mary, I thought I had murdered you.
Mary.
I tried to end myself. We've been through the same horror.
We are a disease, Jonathan. A sickness that corrupts all it touches. All we kiss, and all we kill. Look at me. Admire your ilk.
I'm so sorry.
This is what we've done.
Apologies will not suffice. I demand reparation. I want a miracle. Are you a miracle worker, Dr. Reid? No? I'll show you mine then. The family Reid, reunited and complete, living forever in a red sea of eternal love. Time to go, Mother. Say hello to my son for
Mary,
me.
Mary, wait. I have made friends. With vital knowledge, vampires. We are not alone, Mary. With time, we can learn to live almost as we lived before.
Don't do this, Mary.
How long?
What?
How long will this masquerade continue? I've been watching you. All these nights in Whitechapel, pretending you're still a doctor. You believe you're just fighting a disease. But it's you, the disease, Jonathan, you!
I'm a scientist. I'll find a solution. Let our mother go, please.
You're always the one to sway me to reason, Jonathan. But before, your motivations were always pure. Now you're tainted.
Let her go! She has no part to play in this.
Very well. Have you heard our good doctor? You can go home, Mother. Go home and rest in peace.
Yes. I'll go home and rest.
It's so easy to make them obey or forget, puppets for our pleasure. I've seen you have your fun.
You are mad.
Oh, so that's what I am, Doctor, mad. I was beginning to wonder. I've been hearing these voices in my head, one in particular, that of my dead brother. This is the reason I must kill you. Not for your betrayal, not for our poisonous kiss, not even for the lies you tell yourself. No, it's so that smooth and wicked voice will stop ringing in my ear.
Mary, no, don't!
Time to die, brother, and this time for good.
Abomination!
Done.
What the hell is that?
Jonathan.
Kinslayer.
Take the fire out of you again.
Well, brother, it's time to bring this conversation to an end forever.
You know, I will not play this game.
Calm now, Doctor. Like a rabid dog, or think you're performing an autopsy?
Don't be ridiculous.
I'll kill them all. The kind Dr. Swansea. The sweet little lass with hair of red. I am the harbinger bringing your punishment.
Kill her, Jonathan. Kill her!
Mary.
For real this time.
Don't you see? This is not me. Flesh that never ages. All nightmare. No dream. Bring it to a close. Let me sleep.
Stay for the chest.
I will find a cure, Mary.
He says that as he kills her.
I swear it.
Then, at last, I can forgive you.
Are we gonna bury her again? Well, let's actually make sure she's dead and buried. Hail Mary, defeat Mary. A few nights later.
Tear for my fallen sister. I realize the entire world now revolves around this singular word. The epidemic that has stricken London is not the Spanish flu.
It is transmitted through the blood via violent biting, turning survivors into frenzied immortals. I am Dr. Jonathan Reid. I am a vampire, born anew into an age of death and pestilence, while plotting factions close in around me. I am sworn to find the source of this epidemic. I am convinced greater perils are still to come. I know the answers I seek are hiding in our blood.
Okay, right, we're going to be ending the episode there. Thank you for joining in. And check out tomorrow's video where we will be starting chapter 4. Rise and Fever, where we find the origin of the epidemic in the West End. Am I going to see a West End show whilst we're at it? Who knows? Please don't forget to leave a like, leave a comment down below, and also hit that subscribe button as well. And I'll see you all in the next one. Bye-bye.